everybody. 92 in the shade. It's Friday. Grinder's warming up. Everything's loaded. We out of here. We'll be heading to Shad, Oregon. Getting ready to race it up. Can't wait. Been a while since I've been on the 250. Been a while since I got a chance to go racing. I'm stoked. Nothing but blue skies and sunshine over here, but it's gonna be about a 3-hour drive till I get there. So see you there, boys. Guys, we have arrived. As you can tell, I'm out riding the bike. This is the start line, or I believe so. Got the two flags sitting out here pointing that direction at the start. The somewhat staging area behind it. I'm just gonna go out and look at the first little bit of it, the first couple sections, and see what it looked like. Hey guys, today is Saturday. About 11, maybe 11:15, something like that. Out here just watching the other guys race, and got some video and stuff of the other classes starting. Maybe I'll throw that in, or maybe that'll be a separate video, whatever. Weather give us a nice reprieve today. It did go ahead and cloud up on us. There hasn't been any rain, but we did get the clouds. Gonna end up being that closer to 70, 80 instead of 95 like it was yesterday. Got about an hour till start time. We'll line up, get in line, get out there and see what we can do today. I'm pretty amazed today. Get the video camera to show you as somebody comes through over there. There's actually not near as much dust as I feared. There is dust, but it's not clouds of dust like I really feared it was going to be. So everything. Next time we catch you, we'll be at the start line. Good luck, boys!
We don't think that was the hot line over there, okay?
Didn't look like it.
Even for an old guy, we've done something different there. You ready? You ready?
just hanging in the air. It's not super cloudy. This shit's dicey. record live with my lap, so had to figure that out. Something in the future I'll try and work on, but at least we'll get to see what my max heart rate was for the day and how crazy it is. one kid in half me. So, may not be a lap down. Maybe. two laps without getting passed. Some kind of a record for me. Of course, that doesn't mean I'm doing good because I still haven't seen height or hair of anyone in my class. But hey guys, just got in from the race. I'm not sure, it's hard to keep track. The three or four laps, checkered, finished. Great track, loved it. Really technical and tight, and lots of switchback corners, and it's very loose dirt, very, I don't even know what it is. Clay that got really dry, cracked apart, and then there's big chunks that are like fucking rocks, and then there's just, the rest of it's just a fighting powder, almost like silt. The more we ride on it, the more silty it's becoming. But great track, loved it. A couple high speed sections where fifth gear tapped out, hold it as long as you want. Oh, fun. Passed a couple people. Not sure if, you know, I know a couple of them had wrecked, but I don't know if any of them were in my class or not. No clue. Got passed by two guys. Think they were pretty, they were the two fastest guys or whatever. I think the rest of the dudes in my class all got an extra lap. So those guys that had passed me that were right in front of me, they're the ones that took the checkered. So then I took the checkered behind them, where the rest of my class had already started the next lap and was out going. So probably be a lap down on everybody in my class, but I only got lapped by two people. So feeling pretty good about it. Felt great during the ride. Took a quick look at my heart rate monitor real quick when I got in. Looked like 189 for max heart rate. Average of 160 something, so definitely pushing it past my max heart rate, which I think was 178 was my theoretical max heart rate. So pushed it beyond that for quite a bit of the race. We'll look at the graph and how long it was up that high and everything later. But felt good through the whole race. I was able to get a drink one of the straight stretches, pretty much right at the end of the last lap. So I probably should have made a point to take a drink earlier, because I can tell I'm dehydrated. I already have sucked down pretty much a whole Gatorade at this point, so I just probably should have stopped and drank more during the race. But great race, amazing. A little bit of dust if someone was directly in front of you, but other than that, not too bad. Me being so slow and being behind everyone, basically everyone pulls away, and then before I ever have to deal with any traffic, it's the next guys coming all the way around lapping me, or anybody that wrecks in front of me gets behind me and then passes or whatever. So I get pretty clean air because I'm so slow. I guess that's not a thing to be proud of, but anyway, guys, I just wanted to do a little recap right after the race. Great race. Flagged pretty well, signed pretty well. Wasn't super hard to follow the course or anything. I didn't think there was anything that was super sketchy, scary, or hard to do or anything. A couple of the logs in the log section, or whatever they call it, the enduro cross section, I killed it twice going over one of them, but it's just literally the bike stalling out. It's not, I can't do it or can't get over the log. So other than that, pretty great race. Look forward to tomorrow doing it all over again. We'll see how bad the pros, that the experienced riders, are going to go out and race another race after us. So we'll see how bad they tear it up tonight. But all right, guys. Later. Hey, YouTube. So it is Sunday morning. Well, not normal morning now. It's about 11 o'clock. Got about an hour till our race starts. Went ahead and signed up again for the race today. Going to go out and give her a shot. Today they're including a mud pit that we didn't do yesterday. It seems the race before us, the 10 o'clock race, used the mud pit yesterday and then didn't do it today, and now we're going to do it today. Us and the experienced guys. So pretty hesitant. I almost didn't race again today because I watched the experienced guys, the pros, go through it yesterday, and even they were having a hard time getting stuck, falling over. It's whatever, you'll see it. Hopefully I'll make it through it, whatever, we'll see. But I just decided, screw it, I'm here. I wanted to get a doubleheader in. I haven't done a doubleheader yet this year. The Lapine one I left early, too sore. This time I'm feeling a little better. I'm not quite as sore, and the cramping and everything went away last night before I went to sleep. So feeling pretty physically good. So I went and looked at the mud hole again this morning. Almost decided not to race and decided, screw it, I'm just going to go ahead and do it anyhow. So we're going to go out and hit it out today and see how it is. The rest of the course I loved yesterday. It was great. Enjoyed the heck out of it. Very, very fast and fun. So I'm hoping it'll be like that today. And then just have to figure out how to get through this mud hole, and we'll be good to go. So all right, guys. Next time we see you, we'll be at the start line. Whoop, whoop. All right. Sunday morning. Lining up on the line. Not quite ready for a start yet, but got blue skies today. A little warmer than it was yesterday. Hopefully we don't roast out. But we'll see you at the start.
Well, I might as well start explaining now why I'm putting the 2 days together and I'm just putting Sunday right at the end of Saturday. That's because here in a second the GoPro is going to shut off, and I've been having this problem. I had the same problem at Tillamook. Basically I've been running an external battery that's in my backpack via a cord to charge the GoPro while we race. Something is shorting out inside that cord, and it's either making it where the GoPro doesn't charge, or it just literally makes the GoPro shut off altogether. And that's what happens right here in a minute. My buddy Danny turns his GoPro on. I hear the beep. I check mine to make sure it wasn't mine shutting off. And then as soon as I'm done checking it, it shuts off. So this is the reason I'm including it all in one, because there is literally no more footage beyond this point right here. So I didn't get any other video of the Sunday race other than My buddy's daughter did some clips outside of the GoPro, like standing on the side of the track. I'm gonna go ahead and include those, but I gotta get my cord figured out or just go back to recording with just the internal battery and just get an hour's worth period. I'm not sure exactly what I'm gonna do yet, but just wanna let you guys know, because I've dealt with this for a couple races now and been trying to make the best of it, trying to figure out what's wrong and what's causing it. So I think I finally got it narrowed down now and I can get it fixed up. So just letting you know.
Hey guys, it's Sunday. Just got done with the race. I got the same dirt mustache going on. Maybe a little worse today. The dust was a little heavier today. But race turned out great. We didn't do the mud section. Awesome. They left it fenced off and routed us around it, so it wasn't the exact same course we did yesterday. They did lengthen it and add in additional runs here and there. You'll be able to see it in the laps, well, if you pay attention close enough. But lengthen out the track a little bit. But same as yesterday, just great. Flowing. We finally got some berms pushed up in some of the spots that have been raced for 2 days. Some of the new stuff didn't have any berms, of course, but it's just an awesome track. We only had one wide open section this time, where before we had two hauling butt. This time we only really had one. That little gravel piece was really short. You couldn't get up to run very good on it. And got the GPS on the heart rate monitor to work. It worked and it GPS'd me, so it got the average speed, top speed, and then drew a little graph of the track. So that's cool. Haven't seen the results yet. Haven't went up and looked at them. Just now getting undressed and getting ready to cool down and put my regular clothes back on. But great race. Didn't crash, didn't go down. Had a little bit of a battle with the other guy in my class. He was faster than me in the tight stuff, but then he'd go down in some of the spots, or did go down in some of the spots a couple times. I got back by him, and then he'd catch me up in the trees again and pass me again, or I'd let him go. So pretty fun. Pretty fun to actually have someone, you know, for most of the race within touching distance. Yesterday's race, once everyone left me, I never saw any of my class ever again. So it was just the guys that were super fast that lapped me that I seen again. But today, with that guy having a couple small offs or whatever, I got to catch up to him, pass him, and kind of have a little back and forth battle. You know, it wasn't because I was as fast as him, just because he was having mistakes. But still pretty fun, man. Still pretty fun. I'm way more tired today. Tired going into it. So, didn't have near as much energy and near as much to pull from as I did yesterday. So, pretty tired, pretty arm pumped out by the end of it, just from so many constant turns. And I kept trying to do everything I could to try and gain corner speed. I went up to third for a while and was using third gear and just really using the clutch a lot through the corners, trying to keep my speed, and tried to stop using the rear brake at all and just roll through, and lost my front tire a couple times trying that. It's just really hard to keep corner speed when it's this soft and slippery. I did my best and hope you guys enjoyed the video. I don't know how much of it got because it was dead when I came in. I've got a problem with the cord that runs from my auxiliary battery bank to the camera. It used to keep it charged the whole time, get 2.5 hours of video. Well, now something's wrong with the cord and it's shorting out. And as soon as it shorts out, it just kills the GoPro. So hopefully I got some video on there. Hopefully the normal life of the GoPro battery, 50 minutes maybe. I hope. Get some good footage for you guys. But what a great race. I recommend it to anybody coming out to the shed race. Great race. You're not going to find super hill climbs. It's all flat country. You're not going to find nasty downhill. There's no hills. There is some mud. They may choose to run it or not. There is a creek that runs through the property. So you might run down the creek, through the creek, over the creek. There's many different bridges. So those are all options for different years. Yesterday, the pros ran in the mud. In the opening morning, the 50 and 60 class ran in the mud. Luckily, somehow we managed to not run the mud. So I'm thankful for that. Thankful for everyone who helped set this race up and promote it and get us out here racing on it. Super awesome race. Thanks, guys.